My name is Matt Sweet. I'm at the Institute for Molecular Bioscience, or the IMB, at the University of Queensland in Brisbane, Australia. The study that I'm going to talk about for JCI Insight was focused on chronic liver disease or liver fibrosis. And this study involved a number of researchers, including from the University of Queensland's IMB Centre for Inflammation and Disease Research, the Centre for Liver Disease Research at the University of Queensland, and also clinicians and researchers at the Princess Alexandra Hospital in Brisbane. Chronic liver disease can arise from many different causes, but in general, repeated rounds of injury results in cell death that leads to inflammation, and ultimately this drives an aberrant wound healing response causing fibrosis or scarring of the tissue. And if this occurs over many years in liver disease, this ultimately results in failure of this vital organ. This study focused on really two key questions around chronic liver disease. The first was asking whether there's a core gene signature that's associated with liver fibrosis irrespective of etiology. There are many different possible causes of chronic liver disease, for example, excess alcohol intake, poor diet and obesity and other cofactors, and also some viral infections like hepatitis C virus. But despite this, in all cases, fibrosis drives disease progression. And so the key question we wanted to ask was whether there is, in fact, a core set of genes that are associated with the development of fibrosis, irrespective of the underlying cause. We undertook RNA sequencing on liver biopsies from patients with different stages of liver fibrosis, and those patients had different underlying etiologies, for example, fatty liver disease, and HCV infection. And so by profiling those patients with different etiologies, we were able to arrive at a core set of genes that were associated with chronic liver disease in different conditions. And from that, we were then able to use a set of biomarkers present in serum from the same patients to correlate that with disease progression as well, which provided independent way of validating our findings. A key finding from that approach was the identification of a transcription factor called ETS homologous factor, or EHF, as a transcription factor that was associated with many fibrosis-associated genes. And in cell-based studies, we could further validate the role of this particular transcription factor in driving the expression of fibrosis-associated genes. We also performed meta-analyses with other publicly available data sets to really further validate our data. And for individual findings, for specific genes and proteins, we could then validate those in independent patient cohorts. So the second question focused on fatty liver disease and was trying to understand whether there's a gene signature that's specifically associated with steatosis in advanced disease. And that's because fatty liver disease, which can progress to non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, or NASH, has a huge prevalence globally, and NASH is a major clinical problem, and there are no therapeutic options currently available for this condition. We performed RNA sequencing, again, from HCV patients, but now segregated those into patients that had steatosis and those without steatosis. And by performing this analysis, we were able to identify a small set of 12 genes that were specifically associated with advanced disease only in those patients that had steatosis. And from this analysis, we could identify potential drivers of fatty liver disease progressing to NASH. For example, a particular extracellular protein called FSTL1, which is a member of the SPARC family of proteins, was specifically elevated in advanced disease in patients with steatosis. So I'd particularly like to acknowledge the contribution of Divya Ramnath, who was the lead author on this study, for not only driving the majority of work in this project, but also really bringing together collaborations from different groups that are associated with the study. And I'd also like to particularly thank Elizabeth Powell, who's a hepatologist at the Princess Alexandra Hospital, for providing the clinical samples for this analysis, but also ensuring that we were asking the right questions for this study.